Okay, in this lesson, I'm going to show you how to cut bell peppers. The first cut we're going to do is going to be a julienne, and then I'm also going to show you how to get a dice. So you're going to get two different knife cuts from one bell pepper. Bell pepper is one of the things that I find people just cut in the weirdest ways. So I'm going to show you how I do it. So I start by cutting off the bottom and the top. And we're just going to put those to the side, and we're actually going to use this for our dice. And then we're going to stand the bell pepper up so you can see all the insides. And what you want to do is look for this white rib, and you want to make sure you cut off the side, and you're just basically going to cut. And after you're done, the only thing you're going to be left with is the middle. And this whole thing is going to go into the garbage. So now you have your sides of your bell pepper nice and cleanly cut. If there were a lot of white pith left on here, or that white rib, I would just go ahead and slice it again and just clean it up a little bit. But I got it on the first pass, so I'm not going to do that now. So with the bell pepper, what you want to do is go ahead and lay it down flat, because that's always the safest bet. So you don't want to put it on the skin side down, because that's kind of a little bit rocky. It's not too unstable, but it's more stable with the interior of the bell pepper on your cutting board, facing your cutting board. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to get my proper knife grip, where I have the two fingers pinching together like this with the blade in between, and I have my, this part of my hand is right at the heel of the blade. So we got a good grip going on. We're not doing any of this. We make sure we have a nice firm grip on the knife. And then with your other hand, you're going to curl your fingers back, and then you're going to use that to stabilize your bell pepper, and then you're going to go ahead and start cutting. And so this is how we get our nice julienne. And you want to make sure that with bell peppers, this skin is actually quite tough. So you want to make sure that your knife is good and sharp. And if it is, then you'll get a julienne cut that looks like this. And you can use this for fajitas, for salad, for any number of things. So what I do, sometimes I may flip it over on the skin side down, because sometimes it's a little bit easier to get through the skin that way, if you find your knife is giving you a little bit of resistance. So, you know, even though the other side is safer, you can do it either way. So that's going to be your julienne. And you're just going to put that to the side. And what you don't want it to happen is for the pieces of bell pepper to be like stuck together and it looks like an accordion. So if that happens, then you know you need to sharpen your knife, or either you need to follow through more on the cut. But you don't need to force down on the knife, because then if you're giving it too much force, that could be a potentially dangerous situation where you force down on the knife and then it slips and then you cut yourself. So there's the julienne. Now I'm going to take the bottom piece, and I'm going to basically do the same thing. I'm going to cut across, and then I'm going to rotate it, and we're going to get some dice out of this. Now, I always dice the tops and bottoms, because you don't just want to throw it in the trash, because it's good food and you paid for it. So you get the dice. This is what your dice is going to look like. And you can throw this into quesadillas or corn relish. Or if you're making a black bean salsa, you can use the dice for that. So with the top, what I do is I just pop out this part. Just take it out like that. And then I don't worry about this white stuff on there. So this is going to go in the garbage. And then we're just going to do the same thing that we did with the bottom. Julienne. Gather everybody back together, give them a quarter turn, and then we're going to run the knife across again to get our dice. And when you dice it relatively small, nobody can even tell that it's from like the odd top and bottom of the bell pepper. Because it's so small, you can't tell that it was like a weird shape to begin with. So that's what your dice is going to look like. So you have a nice dice as well as a nice julienne for your recipes.